from the railway speaker, I will speak on something that probably simple. Under title, the kinetics of NNO2 photoreduction in the presence of humic acid. Already several years, our department interested in research on humic acid producing in Kalimantan. So we find that humic acid from Kalimantan. It is known to be very abundant of peat soil. And the importance, MnO2, manganese oxide, is insoluble in nature. Solubilization of this oxide is important because a variable soluble manganese is essential trace elements as a nutrient for plants. Solubilization of MnO2 is also important. I think it's mentioned in the previous lecture that manganese is play important role in photosynthetic conversion of carbon dioxide and water producing carbohydrates. And the third, manganese is an environmental indicator, and the state and the ratio between manganese 4 and manganese 2 is a good redox indicator for the soil and aquatic environment. Many structure are friendly speaking that humic acid is the structure is not no one know, but many group of research center make assumption. One of the hypothetic structure of humic acids proposed by Stephenson in 1994. This is in general many functional groups present here, but mainly carboxyl groups and phenolic OH group and also alcoholic OH groups. In this presentation, mainly two studies will be presented. The first studies on the humic acid itself and its effects in manganese 2 photoreduction, and this consists of the first physicochemical characteristics of the humic acids and the effect of pH and humic acid concentration on the conversion, manganese conversion. The second studies on the kinetics of the manganese O2 photoreduction or manganese 4 photoreduction in the presence of humic acids. The first, from the data, including unpublished data, we propose the mechanism. And the second, that's experimental confirmation of the proposed mechanism. And this, I think, why I present here, because usually after we have so many experience and data, rather difficult for us in Indonesia to propose something. We afraid to be we still afraid to make that the proposal is not good. But I think it is needed for us to do that. I try with my student to do it. And the first, you make asset. And this is the chemical analysis of the humic acid, the acidity, and the total hydroxyl groups, and also carboxylic groups, compared to what found in literature. This is fully transform infrared confirmation carboxylic group and OH group, both phenolics and alcoholic. This is the pattern of humic acid to solar radiation. When we use solar radiation, when we was artificial or lamp, UV lamp, it doesn't work. We work in UV region only. We measure in UV region only. But we don't use lamp because it doesn't work. No, nothing happen with the humic acid. When we use the lamp, so we use direct solar energy. This pattern, the first curve is pH 7 and the second pH 12. The effect of pH and humic acid concentration. The first effect of pH medium. Here, the yellow curve is the experiments with a percent of reduction in at different pH, from pH 7 till 13. And then the blue one, that's if no radiation. When the C, curve C, is the theoretical solubility calculated from the KSP of manganese dihydroxide, and it is in agreement, the three, it is clear that only with radiation that manganese oxide will be reduced. And this effect of humic acid, if no humic acid was added, no reduction was observed. Here it is interesting that in the control, the humic acid itself, there is an increase, linear increase in the if you make. It seems like we measure the MnO2 reduction. We draw on that, so we use this for correction, because there is humic acid is macromolecule, therefore the solution to be colloidal and give apparently absorption. And on the kinetics, that is on the kinetics. We start our studies with, we call it mechanism. Mechanism is assumption or hypothesis. First, it is reasonable to make a hypothesis that the first step should be the absorption of humic acid on MnO2 surfaces, forming a complex anion. And then, if we expose this complex anion into radiation, the humic acid part of the anion will serve as an antenna to absorb UV radiation. And then, something like this. So, this is the model of the humic acid. And then the other, the MnO2, the solid MnO2. And then, we can have model like this. And then it is a complex anion. So in this part, through PP excitation, this molecule can absorb solar radiation. And then after that, should be used for this compound. The second step, and then under solar radiation, the complex anion would absorb radiation energy, causing P star electronic transition from the delocalized P electron in the aromatic system. Something like this. So this is the excited state anion, and then this transition state, the complex anion can this. Transition state and there is an electron transfer from the ring of the aromatic and to the manganese and forming this form. So this left a positive charge, and that is manganese 2. Of course, it is need a proof of this. Experimental confirmation. In the presence of humic acid, photoinductive reduction is pH dependent. We saw already. An appreciable reduction was observed at pH more than 3. Reaching a maximum at pH of 10, suggesting the formation of complex anion, probably as intermediate, proposed plays an important role. The second, strongly acidic medium, pH less than 3, the formation of such paper complex anion could not be expected, since all functional groups of the HA of the humic acid are well protonated. The third, at pH between 4 and 5, carboxyl group is in the form of carboxyl ion, which is attractive for a complex anion formation. Moreover, is in strongly alkaline medium, pH more than 10, the carboxyl and hydroxyl groups are agreeable in their anionic form, giving possibility for the formation of anion complex. The data, in the following data, the data show that without electromagnetic radiation, aromatic anion complex form was energetically unfavorable for such reductive dissociation, resulting in anganese 2. On the contrary, the electromagnetic radiation reductive dissociation of anion complex seems energetically more favorable, since the electromagnetic radiation resulted in an excitation for the delocalized p electron in the complex anion. The third similar reason has been reported earlier by other people. This is the data. Without solar radiation, we have, in this first order kinetics, we have rate constants of 4.2 times 10 to minus 5, and in the other side, with solar radiation, much more a faster reaction. Yeah, this is 4, and then this 100 times. In the dark condition, of course, then the intermediate complex is stable. In the condition, only very small portion of the intermediate complex are in excited state without radiation, resulting in unfavorable condition for the reduction. The table data confirm also experimentally that reduction is not possible without solar energy. But if you look closer into the data by addition of oxygen, so we have two experiments. In the left hand side we have nitrogen atmosphere, in the right hand side we have air atmosphere. This is without oxygen, in that one with oxygen. This is about two times the reduction. It means that oxygen plays a role. We thought that radical, because oxygen is radical, play a role. This is when we use propanol 2. Propanol 2 is a radical scavenger specific for OH radicals. The data is like this. So the reduction decreases. but never been zero. Although we had already more than 40% or 50% of Prapanal 2. This means that without solar radiation, without oxygen, in fact, reduction may happen. And this is so the conclusion can be the first, in aqueous medium, the presence of humic acid plays an important role in photoinductive reduction as photosynthesizer. The reduction efficiency is dependent on the medium acidity. The reduction efficiency increases as pH increases. It was observed, however, the application of medium pH, high pH, could not be realized in practice. Since at pH more than 10, the manganese to produce by the reduction will be precipitated. The second, manganese to photoinductive reduction in the presence of humic acid producing soluble manganese 2 was governed strongly by an internal electron transfer within the intermediate complex anion proposed, resulted in chemical absorption of the humic acid on manganese 2 manganese oxide surfaces. It was observed that without any electromagnetic radiation, no reaction was observed. Under solar radiation, however, the reaction rate increases considerably. And there was evidence that some radicals plays a role by the addition. Since the presence of excess propanol 2, which should remove all radical presence, only about 60% decrease in the reduction efficiency. So, radical other than OH radical probably also involved. Number 4, it was also observed that the presence of iron 3 in manganese 2 as oxidizing agent up to 1% did not alter the reduction, suggesting the role of iron 3 in the degradation of humic acid producing smaller organic molecules was not as important as reported by other people. That's all we have. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So much, Peter. So does anyone have any questions? Keep putting your hand in the middle. Scratching your head. Okay. I have something I'd like to ask. So if the humic acid is acting as a photoelectron donor, yeah, to manganese 4 to generate, to initiate the reduction to manganese 2, it might have a luminescent excited state. Have you considered the possibility of doing luminescence measurements?
Not yet. You better get it in line.
Okay.
Yeah.
Any other questions from anyone? Everybody's tired and wants their tea. If not, okay, please join me to thank